Good afternoon. My name is Sri Krishna. Many of you know me. I teach in the Public Policy and Development Program. I was asked to introduce Mr. Kulandai Francis. For me, it's a very deep honor to introduce Mr. Francis. I have learned a lot from him as a student. He was an inspiration for me when I was writing my dissertation. Our paths crossed after 10 years, once he won the Magsaysay Award. And from then, we have become good friends. And Mr. Francis is a very close friend of our university. It's very difficult to describe Mr. Francis. I could probably just read out the text that you've been given, but it's very dry. If you can imagine a small village in the middle of nowhere, nestled amongst some hills with a river nearby, filled with very poor tribals, and the only thing available in that village is a church. This is in the 1970s. It would sound very much like a story from the Wild West, but imagine a setting of that sort, a village with a river and a church, and a young man, possibly in his 30s, with a beard, a little bit hefty, walks in as a father, as a priest. And from there, he walks for almost 2 or 3 years, anywhere between 15 to 20,000 kilometers, by himself, village to village, serving the people. And then he chucks it up and he says, by being a Christian monk, I can only serve Christians, but I want to serve humanity. And Christianity confines me. And so he chucks up his theological training and he starts making mistakes in development. He learns from those mistakes from the 1990s. Eventually, when I met him, Mr. Francis had a vehicle which he would rarely use. He would go around in a sputtering TVS 50, right, at that time. Very modest, I never knew him. The person before you today has dispersed, because of his own credibility, an equivalent of around 4,400 crores in three districts of Tamil Nadu, Krishnakiri, Dharmapuri, and Velur. Mr. Francis is, in our audience, in a very cosmopolitan, urban audience, is known as Mr. Francis. But to people in Krishnagiri and Velur, he is more appropriately known as Swami. Swami is something akin to a guru or a god. And I won't be understating that. I'll just give you an instance. We were traveling with him one day, and we took a small loo break. We went to the side. And we were just standing near a tree, and a couple in a motorcycle whizzed past us, but they saw that Mr. Francis was standing there, and they noticed and they stopped. This was a relatively elderly couple. And they got off the bike, and they walked up to Mr. Francis. But before they walked up to him, they removed their chappals to the side, and then they came and spoke to him. This is the reverence that the people in his area have for him, and rightly so. It is indeed, and very rarely do we come across people who, by the sheer dint of hard work and honesty and belief in themselves, rise to become such a star. Right? Today he runs, I don't know how many things. I can't remember. He serves more than 150,000 households in three districts. I'll give you another example. There's a girl here, Lokapriya, who came for an MA in education. I had gone for I'll stop with this last instance so that he should speak. I had gone for an admission talk to a government college in Krishnagiri, soliciting applications to APU. And I, of course, started speaking, and there was not much traction. And then Mr. Francis then started speaking. And then something struck him. He said, and they're all boys and girls of your age. He said, how many of your mothers are members of my self-help group? And one by one, the hands started rising. I rarely saw any hand that was not there, right? So to me, even I'm a faculty member and I'm a public policy person, but to me, he's in some ways a guru, and in many ways, he's a guide about how one should promote development. So very sincerely, Mr. Francis, please welcome you again.
Good afternoon. See, I need not tell much about me because already Professor Krishna told a lot of things about me. First of all, you should look at me not as a scholar, not as a professor, not as a teacher. I'm just a field worker. I'm a field practitioner. So don't ever think that you are attending a college classroom that I will give you a good talk, a good speech with all high language and all. Just forget all those things. Just you are here, just listen to my story, that's all. See, I was born in a very, very poor family. I was only one sent to college. To send me to college, my parents lost their only property of land. Due to that, I was really affected because I was only one educated. I did my commerce in Annamalai University. Then once the whole property is lost because of my college studies, it affected very much. I felt very guilty. Even whatever I do help to my parents or sisters, it is not up to the mark. Then I felt that I should do something to the society. That's why I joined, since I come from a Christian background, I joined Fathers of Holy Cross to become a priest. So 1970, I joined Fathers of Holy Cross. At the time, I was asked to send to Bangladesh War. 3 months, I worked in Bangladesh border area, worked as a relief worker. Then I went to Pune to study philosophy and theology. Then I was asked to go to one remote village to stay with the people. That's the village where I started my project. 1975, I went to Natrampalayam, where there were one village is called Sesra Ibrahim, a Catholic population. Most of the people came from Metro Dam, because when the British government built the Metro Dam, the land was submerged then. So these people migrated to this forest area. They occupied the area, they cultivated, destroyed the forest, and they cultivated their land there. There I went there in 1975. 1975, there is no road. You have to walk 25 kilometers to reach that village. From Wokanikal, everybody knows it is a waterfall. From there, 25 kilometers to reach that place. From Ancheti, if you go this area, from Osur, Tenikote, Ancheti, there's another 25 kilometers to walk, and we have to reach the place. Like walking only, I went to, along with my friends, another two or three people went and reached and stayed with them 1 year. That is the year I really learned. After all, I am coming from already poor family. I was really, you know, what is the poverty, what is the starvation, everything I knew. But that village really moved very much. There was nothing in the village. There is no drinking water. There is no hospital. There is no school. There is nothing there. There is no water for irrigation, even for drinking. So then when I see the village, then I felt that when I go back again after 1 year experience, that I can be a priest, I can go somewhere else to do the job. But I thought I should do something for these people. I realized that I left the congregation, then I started to stay with the people. That is my change in my life. Once I went to religious congregation to be a priest, now after seeing that village, I changed my point to do social work in 1975, stayed back in the village. There I only, the starvation, in say, not probably 1975, 76, 77, 78, just lived with the people. Only the starvation, there is no drinking water, there were a lot of migration. People used to go to Bangalore, Andhra for search of food. Sometimes people used to eat some kind of leaves or root from the forest. I saw that few people were dying without food, malnutrition, everything. Then I found there is two burning issues with the people. The one is water, another is there is no financial movements in that area. There is no loan facility. People are mortgaged their land, debt traps, and for a small amount of money, they sell their children for mortgaging their children for work. And most of the landlords occupied the area, and most of the money lenders, they occupied the area. It was completely different scenario in that area. Then I thought something must do with these people. So that's why I identified two problems. That is, one is water, another one is loan, debt trap. So first we build a model check dams to collect the rainwater. So that rainwater we collected small way. Then once the rainwater is collected, the water table has been gone up. Then I felt, okay, this is maybe the good program for the people. Then I multiplied the check dam with the help of Belgium government, and we built more or less 331 check dams in that area. Once the check dam has been built, that the main issue is loan facility. So at the time when you give loan also, the bank is not approaching that. Because the bank, there is no facility bank come over there. So with the foreign aid, we thought of distributing loan without interest. Then we thought we can do with groups. That is, we started with a men group. We distributed a lot of money through the men group, but they were not punctual. They were not accountable, and we lost lot of money. Not lot of money, is not simple money. Millions of rupees we lost. We gave to people, but they created asset, but they never repaid the money. We all called for, once they get the loan, they won't come for a meeting also. So we were wondering what to do with, how to go about this. Once we have built check dams, it's going on. It's really giving a lot of improvements, and the water table is increased. People are cultivating, but we need loan to improve their standard. And we cannot distribute the money simply. So that men group really got failure. So we were wondering in that. Then only we thought of going for women group. The beginning 1985, we started a women group. Beginning 1985, the first women group started, the name is called Anne Velangani. Still the group is functioning. Almost 31 years the group is functioning, still today also the group is functioning. But the men, women group, they are very punctual and trustworthy, and whenever they call for the meeting, they used to come, and it was really gave me a good signal. So from there, we really started, it may be a good vehicle to go about the women group, and we can empower the people, we can change the people's life. So in the first women group we started, they started to save only 1 rupee or 2 rupees or 5 rupees. That is the time they can save, that 1985. But now the things are different. And once the groups are coming, there's a self-help group is called savings and credit. Once they do savings, their savings also they have to rotate by themselves. By rotating and doing their good progress, then they will be linked to the bank. That is a self-help group. It is completely different from microfinance. So microfinance is completely different from self-help group. So microfinance is a licensed money lender. And they, you can see in Andhra Pradesh, a lot of microfinance. They is a profit-making company. And they lent, they form a smaller group, and they lent the money to their members. But here, self-help group is not. The self-help itself is an institution, and they form their own groups. The members can be 15 to 20 members. They have their own rules and regulation. They do savings. The savings can be rotated. And people can be linked to the bank. That is called self-help group. Once the self-help group is really interested, then once they show their good interest on that, then we link to the bank. So by linking to the bank, we need several training where they should maintain their own accounts, like cash book, GL, ledger, everything they have to maintain. So IVDP started to give accounts training and how to manage the group, the animators, leaders training, enhancement training. Once of training, we are started to give the group, and the group becomes really empowered. Then they link to the bank. Once the group is linked and the bank is giving a loan, really we act as a moderator only from the group. The group has three types of loans. One is Sangha loan, another is bank loan, another is IVDP loan. Sangha loan is coming from Sangha savings. There is another loan called in Sangha also, special loan. Once the Sangha loan is based on their savings, after giving the loan, if there is money left, then again also they, from the Sangha loan, they can give a special loan to some members, those who need it. That's called a special loan. Then bank loan, based on their group savings, four times they can give the loan. Suppose the group has 10,000 rupees savings, they can give 40,000. Group has 1 lakh, they can give 4 lakh. But the maximum loan, the group can get 5 lakhs. But the 5 lakhs, they won't give to 50% of the members first time. Once the 50% of the members, they pay back their loan, and another next year, another 50% of the people can get the loan. This is the pushback system. So that's what the bank loan is given. IVDP loan, we have small corpus fund, and that money is given for the toilet building or a home appliance, something we are giving there. So if you look into the bank loan, cumulatively, the Sangha loan, so far we have given up to now 2,360 crores we have given to the people, because these groups now spread over. First we started in Notre Dame Palayam. By seeing the result of that, then we went to Krishnagiri, the entire district, and we have started all the blocks in self-help groups. Now so far at present we have more than 10,000 groups. In the Sangha loan alone we have given 2,360 crores we have given. Bank loan, same way, equal, more or less equal amount, the bank loan also is gone. More or less the bank loan also gone up to 2,347 crores has gone. IVDP loan has gone up to 102 crores has gone. But once the people get this money, they're using for different type of program, income generating activities, purchasing land or creating asset, all sort of activities they're doing. The money is, since it's going through the woman, it has its own very good impact on that. So the people use the money very properly. And if you give the money to the man, instead of giving to the woman, it's a lot of differences there. So that once the woman group is going, that the money is very well utilized and utilized for the welfare of the family. They use for all type of welfare activities also in the family, like education, health, and income generating activities, buying a new land, house building, everything and all. Once the group is well formed, then we cannot manage the groups. So it doesn't be divided into different clusters. And suppose that in one particular area there are 200 groups, there are 200 groups, it made into a cluster. So the cluster also, out of the 200 animators or 250 animators, they form a cluster. They elect office bearers, like 6 to 7 people. They have their own accounts. They maintain the cluster, all their monitoring purpose. IVDP as a core body, they will monitor from outside. We will act as a facilitator. So the cluster also given different kind of trainings to maintain the groups. We have, so altogether 57 clusters we have, and 390 cluster staffs are working on this program. Once you have managed all the money, then there are a lot of risk problems there, loan repayment, all these things. But for avoid that, we have a risk management. One of the risk management, we ask the groups also create a reserve fund. Once the group is mature, 3 years old, then certain amount of money is put into reserve fund. It is, suppose 3 years, 25,000, 5 years, 50, 7, 8 years, 100,000, 120,000, like that, we are creating a reserve fund. It is now up to 80 crores we are having a reserve fund. This reserve fund use any eventuality, any problem in the group, we can pull that money, we can cover that group problem. Group also has a dividend. So the dividend comes from the Sangha loan. Group has their own savings, and the savings is rotated by the group, and with the interest, that interest is as a income for the group. So when how the dividend is calculated, that interest plus minus of their group expenditure, the balance is the dividend. So every year, the group can take the dividend from their Sangham. So far, we have given 330 crores as a bonus or a dividend for the group members. The beginning, even today also, even the men group, there are men groups, they cannot get good loan from the bankers. But IVDP groups, there is no problem for getting any bank loan. The credit also is not the before, it was not accessible to the poor people. Now it's very well accessible to people. They can maintain any amount of loan from the bank and they repay the amount. So IVDP group is a really role model for the entire Krishna Reddy district. If you go to any bank, they ask for IVDP groups, the loan is not a problem from the bank side. Then it becomes a real role model for other SHG things. And also this group has a self-respect because they pay 100%, almost 99.9% repayment. And women has a kind of self-respect in the family. And also they create a lot of assets. The children, they send their girl children to the schools and colleges because women are handling more money in that thing. The woman has more decision-making power in the family. So, and also the child marriages dropped, school dropouts has gone down. So many things have developed. We are not using the group only for a loan and a credit. Are the savings and credit. It is kind of holistic approach. And we are also using them for using good drinking water, using the RO water, purified water, sanitary napkin, then solar light from come out of the kerosene things and all your energy. That's why we are having kind of holistic approach, not only credit and savings, but also for health activities also using these groups. So the group has a very good respect among the bankers and everything they have achieved. Kind of, they are so far they have availed 4,939 crores as a loan. Most of the loan has gone for create assets. And the loan also it is given reducing balance. It is not microfinance. When you give microfinance, it's a flat rate loan. All the loans are given a flat rate and high interest rate. Here only based on the bank system. Once we give a 12% interest, once the people repay the loan, the principal amount also reduce the amount only the interest is calculated. And also, not only that, we also have a social group also as a social responsibility. IVDP also, based on that, we do a lot of social action responsibility program. Like, we concentrate on the members. We give a lot of scholarships for the first generation children among the SHG members. Even among the SHG members, we give a lot of scholarships for the widow's children. There are students widow in the colleges. You have seen widow's children, but we have seen students' widow. If you go to the government college in Krishnagiri somewhere, we can see a lot of students are widows. They already, child marriage took place, then they already became also widow while studying in the college. So that also, we are also having a program for the students' widow scholarship program. So even the Krishnagiri district, one of the backward district in Tamil Nadu, that even if you go back to 10 years back, I was a retired CEO at the time, he was a chief education officer. It was only the 50%, 60% pass result in 10th and plus two. And once he came and approached me, you have to improve the standard because most of the poor children are studying in the government school. Then we came with the idea of a question bank. And the past 10 years, you are sprinting this question bank, giving to all the schools free of cost. Every year we are spending more than 6 million for this project. So like that, then the percentage of 10th and plus increased up to 90 to 95%. Now it is a Kishinhari district. So it's not no more backward in education also. It is gone up because of our question bank. So far from our money, IVDP money, we have spent 19 crores for this educational program. There is another program, we call it a solidarity fund, life security fund. This fund, what happens when the group members are there, suddenly they die. After the death, who will pay the loan? Usually in Kishinhari district, it's a border area. People marry, then they leave a wife and they come to Bangalore, they marry another girl. So it is a migration, not only job, it's migration wife also. So it is a big pitiable case. So once the death happens, and usually the husband, even while she's alive, they don't care, and after death, who will pay the loan for her? So nobody pays the loan for her. So the group, it is a kind of big problem for IVDP, because once the member dies and the husband doesn't care, then the group becomes a default to the bank as well as to the Sangha loan. So then we created a kind of solidarity fund. So suppose this year 500 death happens among the group members, the bank loan is amount individually 50,000 rupees. So on the 500 death, then group, from the solidarity fund, they have to pay 50,000 rupees to the death family. So from that money, they can adjust them. If at all there is a default, they can adjust the bank loan. That's called a default life security fund. So from that fund, it is contributed by the group members. So far, they have contributed 16.58 crores. They have contributed, members contributing every year for the death member. It is shared by all the members. Suppose there is 500 people death, means there are 200,000 members are there. It is divided by 200 crores divided by 200,000 members. So every day they contribute maybe 150 rupees or 170 rupees each member. They pay to the deceased family, the death family, they give that money. Then also once the death happens, also they pay from the group fund, they pay 5,000 rupees as a burial expenditure. Why I'm saying that the burial expenditure is so important? In a village, sometimes people fight for the burial expenditure. So the husband, or father, or mother died. Children, they will fight for the expenditure of the burial. So this should not happen to the IVDP SHG members. Once the death happened, they should give a decent burial in the family. So the group has to pay 5,000 for the burial expenditure. This is also another solidarity activities by the members. And also we educate the members when any disaster happens in the country, they should also contribute. Because they are poor doesn't mean they are not responsible for their social responsibility. So for that disaster management, they have contributed 2 crores for that. Kargil war, 2.5 lakhs they have contributed. Gujarat earthquake, 3.4. Balance control program, 2 lakhs. Tsunami revolving fund, 27 lakhs. Thane relief fund, 10 lakhs. By recent flood happened, 2015, they have contributed 1.5 crores for that flood relief. They also constructed, you can see the house. They are constructing a house for the 300 houses are constructed. Each house costs 50,000 rupees. It is constructed in Kadalur district in Tamil Nadu. So all the money comes from the SHG members. So it shows that people feel that I am poor. I am only bound to receive money from the government or people, but I have nothing to give back to the society. But it is not, in our case, we tell them, you have also got some responsibility to share, take care of your brother when there is in trouble. So all these programs, we have some values and ethics. We always educate our staff and animators some moral values. And our IVDP is 100% non-profit. And also IVDP is non-religious, no caste, no greed. We have members from all the religion. IVDP supports disaster management, liberal contribution, clothes and food, money, anything happens to the society. IVDP has a lot of many welfare programs, their families. It's one of the programs, life security fund and funeral expenditure. Members, children, we have a lot of scholarship program, especially for the first generation and widow scholarship. we are always maintaining within our structure. We have no foreign aid, we have no government aid, we are completely self-reliant. How you are managing this program? Whatever the bank loan we are promoting to the SHG members, they have to contribute for the maintenance for 2%. If the member gets 10,000 rupees loan, she must contribute 200 rupees. That's all for her expenditure. With this, my income only, we maintain the federation, we maintain the IVDP. Suppose this year we are giving 300 crore loan to our members, we get 6 crore as an income from the members' contribution. With that, we maintain our federation, we maintain our IVDP, we save some money, we give back to the society as a scholarship, like a first generation student scholarship, Rose scholarship, book printing, everything we do. And also most of our SHG members are more than 15 to 25 years old. It means they have a faith on our IVDP. So we have a lot of indicators to measure whether we are going in good direction or not. One of the indicators, prevention of child marriage. When I started the beginning, lot of child marriage. Now, after people are coming to the self-help group, they have access to money, they have access to loan, and they can educate the children. Once the girl children are going to schools and college, they can prevent the child marriage. So always we concentrate, most of the groups, we track the children, especially girl children, whether they're going to school or not, whether they're going to higher level or not. That way we have prevented a lot of child marriage. And wherever we are working, there is no money lenders. 100% money lenders are completely eradicated. And school dropouts are more or less, even our SHG members, almost 100% dropped out. So a lot of children are going for higher education. And also, we are using a lot of solar energy to eradicate the currency and all sort of things. And also, we use WASH program, water and sanitation hygiene program. Due to our question bank program, the educational standard has been increased in Kashmiri district. So our highlights of the total highlights. We have total groups of 10,554 groups now. We have 1,95,249 members, 57 clusters. Savings, we have 433 crores. A dividend, 330 crores. Security, solidarity security fund, we have given 16.58 crores. Disaster management, 2 crores. Educational service, 19 crores. This 19 crores also comes from 2% service charges. We are not getting this money from anywhere. It falls from the people only. Sanitation program, we spent 129 crores. Cumulatively, we have given so far 4,939 crores we have given to people. So we have two videos we have followed by that. One video about solar energy, another one my Magsaysay Award citation. So followed that, you can ask, if you have, anybody has some doubts, we can ask me questions. So thank you.
In India, nearly 75 million rural households have no access to reliable electricity and are still dependent on harmful kerosene as their primary source of lighting. But today, I am not here to talk about darkness or despair. I am here to talk about change powered by solar energy that is cleaner, safer, and brighter. Namaste. I am Pankaj Tripathi and I am here in Krishnagiri district of Tamil Nadu to tell you the story of D-Light's partnership with IVDP, a partnership that completely eradicated the use of kerosene from 2,000 villages in a short span of 1 year. IVDP, or Integrated Village Development Project, is a community development project that was started in 1979 by Ramon Magsaysay Award winner Mr. Kulandai Francis.
I came from a very poor family. So after finishing my graduation, I thought I should do something for the society. That's why I started this organization officially in 1979. since that we have met a lot of fire accidents, especially in those days when the early stage when you are working in the tribal area. One time there was a fire accident, so all the village houses are got burned down. It is only due to the kerosene lamps, which there is no alternative. Generally, we used to get some 50, 60 fire accidents per year. See, fire accidents is not an easy thing. People are already poor. And when there is a fire accident, the death have occurs, and they lose all the property. Everything they lose.
నీకంతా మా ఎప్పనోళ్ళ ఇచ్చి పంపించరితాకే పంపించి బయట పోయేసి వచ్చేపాటికి ఎంత కాలిపోయిందే ఏమి వీసే హెక్కలే
అండ్ యూఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఫర్ ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ సొల్యూషన్ ఫర్ దిస్ పీపుల్ డిలైట్ కంపెనీ వి కేమ్ ఇన్ టు కాంటాక్ట్ ఫస్ట్ వీ బాట్ సమ్ ఫ్యూ ల్యాంప్స్ గేవ్ టు అవర్ స్టాఫ్స్ దే యూసింగ్ దర్ ల్యాంప్స్ దెన్ దే గేవ్ ద గుడ్ ఇంప్రెషన్ సో ది డిలైట్ ఇస్ గుడ్ రియలీ ఇట్ క్యాన్ హ్యావ్ ఎ ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ సొల్యూషన్ ఫర్ ద పవర్ Technically, we are covered more than 2 million people, but physically, we are covered 1 million people.
IVDP's self-help group leaders demonstrate the usage of D-Light solar lights to their members. They also educate them about the benefits of switching to affordable, cleaner, safer and brighter solar lighting. As users of D-Light solar products, the group members in turn influence their relatives and friends to purchase these high-quality lights through them.
Almost each house they have two lights or three lights. We are completely 100% eradicated kerosene lamps in 2,000 villages. There is no single fire accident due to kerosene lamp.
The D-Light IVDP partnership has certainly made households safer from the harm caused by the use of kerosene. Now, there is no stopping them from getting ahead in life.
பசங்களுக்கும் ரொம்ப புவராக மார்க்கெல்லாம் ஸ்கோர் பண்ணிகிட்டு இருந்தாங்க. அவங்கள ஐடென்டிஃபை பண்ணி ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸை நாங்கள் கேட்கும்போது ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் வந்து இந்த மாதிரி எங்களுக்கு எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி ப்ராப்ளம், நைட்டு 7 o'clock மேலே எங்களால் படிக்க முடியல அப்படி. அப்போது நாங்கள் IVDP அப்ரோச் பண்ணி அவர் டிலைட் எடுத்து எல்லாருக்கும் கொடுத்தார். இந்த பொண்ணு ஆனந்தின்ற வந்து 493-500 செகண்ட் ரேங்க் டிஸ்ட்ரிக்டில். குடிசை வீட்டில் தான் இருக்கா, எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி கனெக்ஷனே கிடையாது. அந்த டைமில் ஷீ இஸ் யூஸிங் த டிலைட். ப்ளஸ் டூவில் வந்து 79-93%, டென்த்தில் வந்து 95%லேருந்து 100% ரிசல்ட், நல்லா இம்ப்ரூவ் ஆயிடுச்சு. அதுக்கு வந்து ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தது.
நவ் ஸ்டடி அண்ட் ஒர்க் கண்டினியூ அன்இன்டரப்டட் ஆஃப்டர் சன்செட் அண்ட் ஈவன் பிஃபோர் சன்ரைஸ்.
இந்த லைட் வந்ததுக்கு பின்னாடி எங்களுக்கு பூ பறிக்கிறதுக்கு ரொம்ப ஈஸியாக இருக்குது. இப்போ இந்த லைட் வராததுக்கு முன்னாடி பொழுது வெடிஞ்சு தான் பூ பறிப்போம், இருட்டெல்லாம் பூ தெரியாது. லைட் வந்த பின்னாடி 1 மணிலேருந்தே பூ பறிக்கிறோம். பூ பறித்து பெங்களூருக்கு 4 மணிக்கு அமிச்சிங்கன்னா ரேட் வந்து அதிகமாக விற்கிது. மாதத்தில் வந்து 3000 ரூபாய் கிடைக்கிறது வந்து 8000 ரூபாய் கிடைக்கும். அதிக வருமானம் வர்றதுனால விவசாய செலவு, பிள்ளைங்களோட ஸ்கூல் ஃபீஸு, மற்ற எல்லா செலவுகளும் பார்த்துக்குறோங்க சார்.
அவர் விவசாயி, விவசாயின்றதுனால நான் வயலுக்கெல்லாம் போக வேண்டியது இருக்கும். அதனால் டார்ச் லைட்டு வாங்கணும், மூணு செல் பேட்டரி, அது மாதம் மாதம் செலவாதியாகும். எங்கள் மனைவி IVDP சங்கத்தில் சேர்ந்தாங்க. சங்கத்தில் சேர்ந்ததுனால சோலார் லைட்டுன்னு ஒன்று அறிமுகம் வந்து இதை வச்சு அவங்க பாருங்கன்னு கொடுத்தாங்க, கொடாங்க கொடுத்தாங்க. 2 வருஷம் கேரண்டின்னு சொன்னாங்க. நல்லா ரொம்ப சேஃப்டியாக இருக்குங்க எங்களுக்கு. தண்ணியில் போட்டாலும் ரிப்பேர் ஆகாது, நீ மேலேருந்து கல் மேலே போடுனாலும் ஒடையாதுன்னு சொன்னாங்க. இந்த லைட்டு எங்கள் வீட்டில் ஒரு நண்பன் மாதிரிங்க.
ரொம்ப நன்றி.
The D-Light IVDP journey that started 2 years back has already impacted so many lives. But we still have a long way to go in bringing a little bit of sun in many, many more homes.
2012 Ramon Magsaysay Award, Kulandai Francis. India is a veritable laboratory of social experiments in the war against poverty. There are spectacular successes as well as uncounted failures. In what succeeds can often be found the story of one person, self-sacrificing, innovative, and impassioned about helping people free themselves from poverty and marginalization. One such person is Kulandai Francis. Born to a poor family in the Salem district of Tamil Nadu, he was the only one of his siblings to go to university. Inspired by the memory of how his parents had sacrificed their only piece of land so he could attend university, Francis resolved to live a life of service. He joined the Fathers of the Holy Cross in 1970, and in his novitiate, did volunteer work among people struck by famine or displaced by war. When he went to live in Natrampalayam, a remote and impoverished part of Krishnagiri district, he had the life-changing experience of sharing in both the people's miseries and their dreams. He decided to give up being a priest to devote himself wholly to social work. In 1979, he began the Integrated Village Development Project, IVDP, in Krishnagiri, starting out with small projects, conducting a night school in the light of gas lamps, setting up a first aid center. Then, with the help of development organizations, IVDP undertook a micro watershed program that over the years built 331 small Czech dams, benefiting cultivators and their families in 60 villages. But still, Francis was not content. Knowing he needed to do something that could be sustained for the long term, even without external assistance. The breakthrough came with the women's self-help groups, SHGs, that IVDP began organizing in 1989. Phenomenally successful, these savings and credit groups have grown into an all-women movement of 8,231 SHGs with 153,990 members, with total savings equivalent to $40 million. A cumulative loan portfolio equivalent to $435 million. In a reserve fund of $8.9 million. What impresses us is not just the movement's scale. IVDP is a financially disciplined, self-reliant, member-owned, and member-managed organization. Group solidarity and access to credit have fueled successful village programs in health and sanitation, housing, livelihood, and children's education, including a primary school for tribal children and a computer training academy that has to date trained some 5,000 children. Francis has accomplished this using an approach that has broken through the financial limits of traditional microfinance approaches. Organized into clusters and federations, SHGs are directly linked to banks through group accounts, bulk deposits, and loans that have given the SHGs the power to leverage preferential bank treatment. At the same time, the women have won respect by demonstrating that the poor can manage their finances effectively and reliably. All this has come to pass because, as Francis believes, quote, when people want to do something, they can, unquote. Despite his organization's spectacular growth, Francis continues to inspire by example living a simple life with the people he is serving. A missionary, in the truest sense, he muses, real happiness comes when I see people are developing, children are improving, and suffering is removed. In electing Kulandai Francis to receive the 2012 Ramon Magsaysay Award, the Board of Trustees recognizes his visionary zeal, his profound faith in community energies, and his sustained programs in pursuing the holistic economic empowerment of thousands of women and their families in rural India.
Any questions? So we'll open it up to the floor. You have any questions? There's a mic around.
Hello, sir. Didn't you face problems like when women were coming out of the houses to meet for the SHG meetings and all, like, didn't men question why are they going out? Like if I see in my society, I guess it's totally difficult for a woman to get out of her house to meet in a private space and all. And second question, what kind of role did the Gram Panchayats play, like in your villages and all, like, if you see in rural settings, there's a lot of play done by the Gram Panchayats and all. So what kind of play did they have in your settings?
In the beginning, when I formed self-help group in 1985, there was a lot of problem from the moneylenders and also village head man and the male society. Usually even their own, the husband doesn't like the woman going out and coming into a group, and they're getting access to money, and they're also having some leadership role, that their own husbands are against that. But in spite of that, we already in the beginning, we had a men group, and with their influence, we asked their wives to come forward and form the group. And they spread a lot of rumors against the men and against the women, all sort of things. That was there. The biggest setback and the problem we got from moneylenders, because moneylenders, you know, they lose the business. And also another thing, that village headman, panchayat headman, and most of the gents are against the women group. But today, of course, we overcome with our perseverance, with our hard work. And if you come to Kishnagiri, many of the villages where we have groups, we don't care about the village headman or panchayat president, because the women are very powerful. They handle a lot of money, they handle lakhs together, millions together. So the money gave them a lot of power to women, and they take the decision. Even the husband, they're not faithful, they throw the husband out. That much they have the power, they don't care. The money given them enough power. They see their, send their girl children to schools and college, their fulfillment, they see through their children. Of course, they cannot go to the college, but they see that the girl children are going to schools. Many women children are today studying doctorate, engineers in our groups. Money is not at all a problem. So this year our transaction could be more than 700 crores this year, Sangha loan and bank loan. So 100% recovery. We don't care about men nowadays. We don't care about the panchayat president. Damn it. We have power. Because naturally it's a male-dominated society, our culture is like that. I think we have to empower the woman. No, there is no other way to balance the society.
Hello, sir. Initially, you have mentioned the two problem you have faced when you had started this mission. The water problem and the financial one. And you have showed in the video that's
I want to know about the hidden, because you have to say that it's a most of the marginalized family and the poor family who had started the journey. So is there the land dam had been constructed on the common lands, or is the dam had been constructed on the common lands?
Most of the dams were constructed in the
common land. That is village Porumboke. A lot of streams are there. Of course, some lands are submerged by the private thing, and we haven't paid any single pipe for the compensation. Everything we manage through the village people's cooperation. So I haven't paid any compensation. Usually, this hill terrain area where we build this five panchayat, we covered through check dams, Natram Paliyam, Mancheti, Koti, Ruri, and Mandal. And recently we had two patches from Azim, Premji. They have seen a lot of check dams also. It is only upgrade water level only. Only people has to dig well and get the water. It is not. So that way we haven't used any private land. We use only government land. We are supposed to get the permission from the government. We haven't got any permission, and everything with the support of the people. No government will try to ask us intervene. So we have done it without permission also. So that is the people's power. Wherever we have a power, nothing works out, many things. So it can go smoothly.
You have mentioned a cluster federation in that, maintain the lots of the SHG. So what is the role of the cluster it's doing on the maintain all the SHG?
The federation nothing bad is there. It is surplus to give IVDP. IVDP cannot
manage effectively the 2,000 villages. So we divided into a few federation clusters. Only it's a monitoring role only. They don't have any financial role. They don't have any financial role. If there are 200 groups, they link to 200 groups, one particular bank. The 200 animators selects a executive body to maintain this administration. Like they have their own staffs. They have office, they have computer, software, everything. All the expenditures spent through these clusters. That's all. Only monitoring role, no financial role. They cannot give any loan or anything. They cannot control. So the group is independent, federation is independent, IVDP also independent. That way we empower each and every stage. We only facilitated and moderated.
You mentioned in the starting that SHGs for men failed due to the lack of accountability. So I wanted to know why was there is a lack of accountability in men? And secondly, with the success of SHGs for women, was there any change in the orientation or inclination of men to participate in SHGs?
Can you explain?
Should I repeat the question?
Yeah,
so I was asking that in the starting, you mentioned that SHGs for men failed. They were unsuccessful because of the lack of accountability. So I'm asking, why was that the case? And secondly, with the success of SHGs for women, was there any orientation or inclination of men to participate more in SHGs? Thank you.
Why men SHGs are failed, you know very well. I don't think I should give a reason. You come to Tamil Nadu, most of the men are addicted to drinks. They are not accountable. And any families you go, and if there is any problem in a family, not because of the lady, because of the man. It is a basic nature of man. It's male dominant. He thinks I am supreme. My wife is inferior to me. So that's why most of the men, SHGs failed. And he is not accountable, because when he borrows money, he is not punctual. He is not coming to the meeting properly. He doesn't come in the meeting, he doesn't repay in the meeting. He gives the money to a lady. She is punctual. She is worried about that loan, because she wants to get back another loan and take care of the family, take care of the children. She all the time thinks about the husband, children. The man goes out, he talks about the international politics. He will talk about Modi, Jayalalitha, everything he will talk. But he will forget the wife, he will forget the children. So that is the problem, it's the culture of man. So it is not, it is a fact. Nobody can deny that. But at the same time, once the women SHGs are successful, they are able to bring loan, they are bringing to solve their economical problem, they start to support their wives, they support the women group. That now they are supporting, there is no doubt about that. That's why it is also successful now. Am I on set?
They are staying from outside.
They will spoil this also. So they should be participate from out. Because they're supporting innovative to send their wife to the group meeting, they borrow money, they utilize for different activities, they repay the money to the group, to the wife, and pay back the money to the SHG. They're doing, they're participating. That way only outside they're participating. Directly they cannot involve in the SHG, that's all. But still there are women SHG, men SHGs are in Tamil Nadu, it is not up to the level of women SHG. It is not successful till today also. They are not able to get a loan. They may get one loan, a second loan, it will take a long time to get another loan because they don't repay it properly.
Actually, whatever I have seen here and I have heard about your SHGs program, I feel that this is not a very easy thing to describe in 1 hour. So do you have some text about all this, about your journey, about your problems, about all the things which you have done for your contentment? Do you have some text or some biography, some something else? And one thing more that
We have a working manual for our SHGs. Of course, we have done a lot of mistakes. Then only we learned also. Each mistake, we create a system. For example, in the beginning, one of the system, I tell you, we gave loan to all the 20 members. Once you give all the 20 members, they go back home, they settle down, they won't come back for the meeting. That's why now we created the system. First, you give 10 members loan. Once they pay 50% of the loan, another 10 members, we give loan. The pushback system. Like that, we create a lot of by doing this.
This mission and how you came to this position today. So this journey I wanted to know more.
Yeah, the beginning I told you, my family was cheated by a money lender.
Okay,
that is a real cause in me. So a lot of families are affected by the money lenders. That's why I want to do some kind of social work for the society. Then I joined for Holy Cross, and then I came back to the social sector. Then once I build a lot of check dams, then we have to give loan finance to the members. Then you need a system to give a loan to the members. So we started men group, it failed, then that's why we came to women group. Women group also, there was a lot of struggle. In the beginning, we had a women group 1989 with the help of government, International Fund for Agricultural Development. We worked with them also. Afterwards, we worked with the government for women groups. But there are a lot of drawbacks in that subsidy program, especially when you give free to the members. One side free, one side loan doesn't work. So we never get any subsidy loan from the government. Thus, we came after the government. We started our own groups. And all these 10,000 groups, no government subsidy, no free concept. Everything, they should get bank loan and repay the loan. So there is no free concept. So that's why we are able to succeed this.
And the second thing is that, as you said, that as you highlighted also, that many things changed in the villages also, and in the life of the women.
There are a lot of case studies are there. A lot of, you see, usually, especially the widows and destitutes, and there is no support in a family and in the village, and this type of groups really brings a solidarity, not a solidarity kind of in a group. And when there is a problem, the woman, they can share, and especially widows and destitutes, they can borrow money from the bank, borrow money from the group. They have self-esteem, self-respect. And the plenty of cases are there, case studies and all. I don't know which case study I have to tell. It's Oh, tell me. Yeah.
A single parent, only my mother. My mother was a member of this SHG. As soon as my father left, we don't know what to do. Because my mother saved some amount. With that amount, my mother had some courage. Because of that, I'm here. So, you can see the life.
Like this, we have at least more than 30% women are in my groups, widows and testudes. It is a big support. IVDP SHG is big support for these people. So you remember in a village, it's a young widow, no husband, going to asking somebody loan. It's very highly risk. I mean what I mean to you. Now, she need not ask. She can take any amount of money from the group, loan, bank. That is a respect. She can lead a decent life. So that she can protect the girl children. So that is the support the SHGs is giving. Yeah, no doubt about that. Yeah.
Sir, I just want to know your views, since in your presentation you had mentioned about philanthropy contribution that had been there. So I just wanted to know your views on how can philanthropy support women, impactful women projects.
Philanthropy activities and education. You mean, what do you mean to say? Yeah. See, usually, why I started this woman group, you know very well, that is the situation fail of that. In a Tamil Nadu, if you go into the village level, they always, they send the woman, the girl children up to 10th standard maximum, or 8th, 10th standard, after they don't send. Why you want to study more than that? So you are going to get married, go to somebody else. They always spend money on the boys. So when I started this self-help group, we gave more important to the girl children. So these children has to be given important. We, in our trainings also, we are given to the women so that you see that even if you don't send your boy to a college, you send your girl to the college. So this girl has to come up. Only the girls comes up, only society can change that. By educating a man, the society cannot change. The only educating a woman, the society can change. That's why even our Tamilian culture, they give important to man than the girl. So that's why we got, now any society, you have to say, you have to give important to the woman. So we have to bring to the mainstream. We have to give equality, no doubt. Otherwise, the society go to dogs. No doubt about that. Already gone to dogs, no doubt. Most of the men are addicted now with the alcohol. So what can you do to this society? No problem. So unless we educate the mother and the girls, only then we can bring a good society today, balanced society. So and the Yemen government, any philanthropy people, even any society institution, they should spend more money on girl children. You can avoid child marriage. We can avoid dropouts. They can be on their own. You can avoid exploitation. There are a lot of sex abuse that are going on and around the India. You see now, even recently, even newspapers also, one side love, and the boy goes and kills the girl. A lot of things are happening nowadays. This, see, this now the society is very sick now. It's not balanced. So we have to bring a balanced society. Otherwise, it's a danger for the future. Even our children cannot be safe tomorrow. Independent. You are asking the transparency of the system?
Individual member?
Yeah.
And you collected such a huge...
Yeah, it is already monitored by the software.
Everything software system is there, accountants is there, and each group, they have, each member has their own passbook, each group they have their own account, bank account, cash book, GL, and audited is done. Each 40 groups, there is one field supervisor, and each 200 groups, there is a federation. Everything monitored through software. So that is all fully transparent. Every year is audited. The audited statement is given to the bank. Without the audited statement, the bank cannot give a loan to us. See, the bank is giving, this year our target is around 400 crores. We are borrowing from the bank. Means, do you think they give simply? We are not giving any security. We are giving our system, our goodwill. That's all our guarantee. So without any guarantee, we are borrowing 400 crores from the bank. So because of our goodwill, because of our system, so they are giving. Everything transparent way is like, because everybody is independent. Am I answered? Oh, okay.
Hello, sir. Sir, I want to know more about the micro watershed project that you implemented in Krishnagiri. And was that your own model? And in what way it helped the people, helped the improvement in livelihood of people? And how much time it takes to regenerate the soil and groundwater level?
No, it is not clear when you use the mic.
I want to know more about the micro watershed project.
Watershed project.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, how it helped the livelihood of how it helped the people to improve their livelihood? Since from the video itself, I could understand people are mainly seeking the agri jobs like rice and floriculture. So, how much time it takes to regenerate the water and soil condition there, and how it helps to improve the livelihood of people in terms of income and?
Water management is a big subject and a big problem. Why Tamil Nadu is facing a problem today is a water management. Not because we don't have water, we have water, but we don't manage properly. And we don't save our water properly. First of all, we must save our own water. Then only you look for water from somewhere else. So whatever my watershed project, it is whatever the rainwater comes around that area, it is collected, it is routed through the thing, the water level goes up. Then they can people go for wells or irrigation pump set, then irrigate the land. So whereas I did Natrampalayam, and after that people gone for a lot of sericulture, mulberry cultivation, paddy cultivation, sugar cane cultivation. So a lot of cultivation employment generates that. So the small watershed project is 11, if you have done all throughout Tamil Nadu, it can generate a lot of employment, it can generate a lot of income for the families, and the water table also will go. So we don't need to fight for water very much from other side. So it is water management is very important. Whatever rainwater we have, that should be collected properly and monitored properly, used properly. So this kind of micro watershed project should give a lesson to many people that they should do that. That's all. So that level will go.
Hello, sir.
How do you see right now, because most of the times in the North India and the SHG had did not success as part of the successful. Okay, what was the reason behind in Tamil Nadu, in the Krishnagiri districts, this type of SHG has been successful model for our country? And lots of, because I have seen lots of SHG has been collapsed right now, but as per your demonstration at here, I have seen lots of the successful, and there's lots of indicator has been impacted on the other sides. So how do you see right now in the SHG, in the model right now?
Yeah, the SHG was, is many places a failure. It is not because of failure due to many reasons. IVDP is a role model now in Tamil Nadu. We are having more than 10,000 crores. It's successful, self-reliant, managed, member-owned, member-managed. You see that we have 390 federation stops. They are not from outside. They are from SHG members. Today you can see the Mr. Vallikannu. She is also SHG member. She is head office in charge. All our stops, all are from the SHG only. It's member owned, member managed. You have to have full transparent for the system. Give importance to the system. Full transparency, no corruption. Definitely, I don't think the system can fail. You need a passion to work for the poor. So that will be successful. Some places are not successful means there's something wrong with who are running the show, who are managing the show, how they're training the people. That may be the reason. When I can be successful with the 200,000 families, why not anywhere? I'm not saying that I have collected only 100 people. I made success, I just show peace, I show model. But it is 200,000 families I'm handling, and it is successful 100% recovery. Any bank is ready to give a loan for us. So why some places are wrong means there is something wrong. Something wrong. You should work for the people, you should work passion for the people, you should commit yourself. Then it cannot be failure. How can it be failure? If it's a good father and mother in a family, do you think the children go wrong? Cannot go wrong. If you have a real good father, how they can children can go wrong? It cannot go wrong.
So just to add, Mr. Francis has been working with this community for more than 45 years. If people are willing to work for a community for 45 years, you will succeed.
Okay, if there is no question, I will conclude myself. Really, thank you very much for this opportunity. I was amazed to be here. I never thought I can be Azim Premji University. Really, thank you very much for your patience listening to me.
I also want to just extend my thanks to Mr. Francis. It's a long-awaited visit. Mr. Francis opens up his organization for a variety of internships of varying kinds. Open to students of all programs, education, development, and public policy. Please reach out to Shruti or if you need to me or any of your program coordinators if you're interested in development and working as interns, right, in IVDP. So thank you, sir. Thank you.